Let's see transformer. Transformer, you must have heard about this name very frequently. Especially in summer cities, normally we come to know that transformer is failed, that's why electricity supply is failed. So it is a device which basically increases or decreases input AC voltage at output. What it does? It has only one function. Either it will increase input voltage at output or it will decrease input voltage at output. So transformers are of two types. Number one is step up. Step up transformer are those which transformer which increases input voltage at output. If I say ES is output voltage, then output voltage is greater than input voltage. Second type of transformer is step up. By name itself, it is very clear. A transformer which decreases input voltage at output. So ES is less than EP. So these are two types of the transformers which are we using practically nowadays. Now coming to the principle of working of transformer. Principle of working of transformer is based on mutual induction phenomenon. Actually in transformer, a rectangular soft iron core made of laminated sheet well insulated from each other, over this we wound two coils. This is first coil, this is second coil. We can call it as primary and secondary coil also. This is an alternating EMF source, E is equal to E naught sin omega t, which is connected across primary coil. These two coils are wound over a soft iron core. Symbolically, we represent with the line soft iron core. So when current, time varying current is passed through the primary coil P1, P2, the magnetic flux linked with the second coil S1, S2 changes and it induces an EMF across it. So you obtain output voltage ES. That's what is the principle and working of transformer. So what if somebody asked only principle asked, then you should write the working of transformer is based on mutual induction. That is, whenever current is passed through the time varying current is passed through the first coil, the magnetic flux linked with the second coil or secondary coil changes, therefore it induces an EMF. As a result, EMF which is obtained at output can be used for any other purposes. Now transformers are operated in two ways in working. One is without load. Without load means no current is drawn at output. drawn at output. What does it mean? You can simply measure EMF, you cannot measure current. That current, how will you obtain current at the output? By connecting through some resistance called resistance. In this case, EMF across primary, we can say NP d phi b over dt. EMF across secondary, we can write ES is equal to minus NS d phi b over dt, and of course where E, NS, NP and NS are the number of turns. In primary and secondary coil. In primary and secondary coil. Dividing these two, dividing equation 2 by 1. ES over EP is equal to NS over NP. This NS over NP is termed as transformation ratio. So for step up, ES is greater than EP. This implies NS must be greater than NP. Number of turns in secondary must be greater than number of turns in primary. For step down, ES is less than EP. That means NS should be less than NP. Right? This is without load. Another way of operation which is very much practical is with load. Operation of transformer with load. I can write this here, EP is equal to E naught sin omega t. Second use is with load. When current is drawn at output, the transformer is said to be with load. I assume if IP and IS are the current in P1, P2 and S1, S2 respectively, then ideally, in ideal situations, input power should be equal to output power. It means EP into IP should be equal to ES into IS. So ES over EP is equal to IP over IS. It means for step up, ES is greater than EP. This implies IP is greater than IS. For a step down, ES is less than EP, this implies IP is less than IS. So when we increase output voltage in a step up transformer, output current increases. However, there are so many losses also there practically that actually we are not counted here. That is little higher to work it out. But so these are the two ways in which you can operate transformer. Now for any electrical device, one thing is very essential to measure, and what is that? Efficiency. And efficiency of electrical device or any device, it may be a transformer also, efficiency is always defined as output power over input power. Ratio of output power over input power in case of the transformer. What actually we want to get from efficiency? Simple, that we are looking forward what we are gaining from the device. If I give 5 rupees to someone in the market, that what we have obtained for this 5 rupees, is it worth or not? So output over input power is efficiency. Output power is ES into IS. Input power is EP over EP into IP. So that's how you can calculate efficiency. Apart from this practical or little theoretical description of the transformer, there are so many losses in transformer. So energy losses in transformer. Very prominent losses are, number one, copper loss. Number two, iron loss. Number three, leakage of flux. Number four, hysteresis loss. Number five, humming loss. Energy. These are very prominent losses in energy. So you can imagine, while you are transferring energy from generating station electrical energy to the tower, there is a loss of energy. While you are getting output from the transformer, energy is being lost in so many forms. So what is copper loss? You know the primary and secondary coils are made up of copper wire, insulated copper wire, and when current is being passed through the insulated copper wire, the heat energy is generated according to Joule's law, I² RT. So technically copper loss is the loss of electrical energy in form of heat energy through primary and secondary coils. What is iron loss? We have kept soft iron core, right? Our winding has been done on the soft iron core. So when alternating current is passed through the primary, and since both the coils are wound over soft iron core, so the magnetic flux linked with the soft iron core is also changes. As a result, a strong eddy currents are generated. And these eddy currents, we know, eventually gets converted into heat energy. So iron loss is basically loss of electrical energy in form of eddy currents and finally in form of heat energy which is radiated into atmosphere. Third is leakage of flux. This arises because of improper placement of the coils. See, if you place copper one first coil here, another coil you place like this, S1, S2, right? Then magnetic flux produced by this coil is not completely linked with the second coil, or second coil you can see some portion is not receiving magnetic flux, or the geometrical size of two coils are different, then the flux produced by the primary coil in larger area cross section than the secondary coil. As a result, the entire flux is not linked and flux remains wasted in the environment. So this is because of the leakage of flux, which is improper placement, improper adjustment or improper arrangement of the two coils. Hysteresis loss. Now when you are passing alternating current, and you have seen is in AC generator, in alternating current after 180 degree rotation the polarity changes. So current flows in first half cycle like this, in second half cycle direction is reversed. So what happens with a soft iron core? Soft iron core is ferromagnetic substance. So for first positive half cycle it gets magnetized. When direction of current is reversed it gets demagnetized, and this is very quick because frequency of AC is 50 Hertz. It becomes 50 times positive and negative in 1 second. So in the process of magnetization and demagnetization of soft iron core, the energy loss occurs, which is termed as hysteresis loss. Humming loss. Some of the part of electrical energy gets converted into sound energy. If you stand near the transformer in the night, you feel a ghost like sound is coming. So it gives a huge sound transformer when it is in operation. It means a part of electrical energy is also getting converted into sound energy. So these are some major losses which occur in transformer. That's all about transformer.